Feasible region. I'll focus on graphing the feasible region with a system of linear inequalities. I'll be graphing with standard form. Standard form occurs when x and y are on the left-hand side of the equal sign and the constant c is on the right. To begin with, I will take the inequality x plus 4y is less than or equal to 28 and change it to an equation. I'll find the x-intercept by letting the y value equal 0. If I replace the y with 0, I get x equals 28. The x-intercept is at 28. The y-intercept occurs when the x value is 0. I replace x with 0. I have 4y equals 28. So I divide by 4. Arrive at a y value of 7. The y-intercept is 7. Now I graphed or created my graph by counting by 2s. Now I draw a straight line. And this line is the line x plus 4y equals 28. But the original statement was an inequality of shading. So I need to decide what side of the line to shade. I'll use a test point of 0, 0, because that point is not on my line and is easy to do arithmetic with. I substitute 0 and 0 into the x and y values of the original inequality. The left-hand side becomes 0. 0 is less than 28, which is true. In most mathematics courses, because that is true, you would shade down where the ordered pair 0, 0 is, because that was your test point. Usually I would shade below that line. But in the problems where we do feasible regions, we shade opposite. So we're going to shade not where 0, 0 is. Shade opposite of where the point 0, 0 is. So I would normally shade below because it was true, but because this was false and I'm doing a feasible region, my false area is above the line. Second inequality reads x plus y is less than or equal to 10. The x-intercept is found by putting 0 in for y. I'd get x equals 10. My apology, I should have changed that to equals. Then I have the y-intercept. I substitute 0 in for x, and I get y equals 10. My x-intercept occurs at 10. My y-intercept occurs at 10. I draw a straight line. I label my line x plus y equals 10. For shading, I can use the same test point of 0, 0. I put it into the original inequality. I have 0 plus 0 is less than or equal to 10, which is true. So I do the opposite from 0, 0. 0, 0 is here. In regards to my line, the opposite of shading this way would be shading above and to the right. My third inequality is 3x plus y is less than or equal to 24. The x-intercept will be 8, 0, because when I put 0 in, I have 3x equals 24, and when I divide by 3, I get x equals 8. The y-intercept occurs at 24. Once again, doing the test point of 0, 0 in the original inequality. I come up with a true statement. True would be to the left of my line. I want to shade where it's false. I only do this when I'm looking for feasible regions. My fourth inequality is x is greater than or equal to 0. This is a vertical line at x equals 0. So it's really the y-axis. If I were to look at the original inequality, it says x is greater than or equal to 0. So the opposite of greater than or equal to, or the false region, would be to the left of my vertical line. And for the last one, y is greater than or equal to 0. This would be a horizontal line at y equals 0, which is really the x-axis. Y is greater than or equal to 0 would be above. For the true aspect, the false aspect would be below. Now the feasible region happens to be the white space that's left. So you can see all of the shaded region around here, if we've been careful with our shading. We can see that feasible region has the corner 0, 0, has the corner at 8 on the x-axis, has a point here that would have to be determined in a different problem, another point, and the point at 7 on the y-axis. That is how you graph the feasible region when you're doing it by hand.